Let us build a house where love can dwell, and all can safely live. A place for saints and children to live. Build up hopes and dreams and visions, rock the faith and vault our
God and Father, we worship.
in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, you have given your only Son to be for us a sacrifice for sin and also an example of godly life. Give us grace to receive thankfully the fruits of his redeeming work and to follow daily in the blessed steps of his most holy life. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
The first reading is from Genesis. Joseph could no longer control himself before all those who stood by him, and he cried out, "Send everyone away from me." So no one stayed with him when Joseph made himself known to his brethren, and he wept so loudly that the Egyptians heard it, and the household of Pharaoh heard it. Joseph said to his brothers, "I am Joseph. Is my father still alive?" But his brothers could not answer him, so dismayed were they at his presence. Then Joseph said to his brothers, "Come closer to me." When they came closer, he said, "I am your brother Joseph, whom you sold into Egypt. And now do not be distressed or angry with yourselves because you have sold me. For God sent me before you to preserve life. For the famine has been in the land these 2 years, and there are 5 more years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvest. God sent me before you to preserve for you a remnant on earth and to keep alive for you many survivors. So it was not you who sent me here, but God. He has made me a father to Pharaoh and lord of all his house and ruler over all the land of Egypt. Hurry and go up to my father and say to him, 'Thus says your son Joseph, God has made me lord of all Egypt. Come down to me. Do not delay. You shall settle in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near me, you and your children and your children's children, as well as your flocks, your herds, and all that you have. I will provide for you there, since there are 5 more years of famine to come, so that you and your household and all that you have will not come to poverty. And now your eyes and the eyes of my brother Benjamin see that it is my mouth that speaks to you. You must tell my father how greatly I am honored in Egypt and all that you have seen. Hurry and bring my father down here." Then he fell upon his brother Benjamin's neck and wept, while Benjamin wept upon his neck. And he kissed all his brothers and wept upon them. And after that, all his brothers talked with him. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is 133. Let us read it together.
Oh, how good and pleasant it is when brethren live together in unity. It is like fine oil upon the head that runs down upon the beard of Aaron and runs down upon the collar of his robe. It is like the dew of Hermon that falls upon the hills of Zion, for there the Lord has ordained the blessing. life forevermore.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. Paul writes, I ask you then, has God rejected his people? By no means. I myself am an Israelite, a descendant of Abraham, a member of the tribe of Benjamin. God has not rejected his people whom he foreknew, for the gifts and the calling of God are irrevocable. Just as you were once disobedient to God, but have now received mercy because of their disobedience, so they have now been disobedient in order that, by the mercy shown to you, they too may now receive mercy. For God has imprisoned all in disobedience, so that he may be merciful to all. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
The sequence hymn is 470. 470.
Slander. These are what defile a person. but to eat with unwashed hands does not defile. Jesus left that place and went away to the district of Tyre and Sidon. Just then a Canaanite woman from that region came out and started shouting, "Have mercy on me, Lord, Son of David. My daughter is tormented by a demon." But he did not answer her at all. And his disciples came and urged him, saying, "Send her away, for she keeps shouting after us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of the house of Israel." But she came and knelt before him, saying, "Lord, help me." He answered, "It is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." She said, "Yes, Lord, yet even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus answered her, "Woman, great is your faith. Let it be done for you as you wish." And her daughter was healed instantly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Because the impurities lie within. Jesus explained that a lot of the evil of the world comes out of the human heart. Evil intentions, murder, adultery, fornication, theft, false witness, slander, and I might add, racism. Bad things don't just simply float around in a random vacuum and kind of bump up randomly against people. Those bad things come from inside us. If nobody ever thought about stealing, there wouldn't be any robbers. If no one wanted to speak ill of anyone else, there would be no slander. What lodges within us and pops out of our mouth is what sullies and taints us. And we all know how powerful words can be, how powerful, with so much energy, and how wounding. If I say to you, seek Heil, you know exactly what I'm talking about. A powerful phrase for evil. And then, of course, there are the powerful phrases for good. God bless you. So let's translate this into modern day Emmaus. Somebody comes into the church with dirty, broken fingernails. Maybe they've been digging in the garden or changing their car's oil. And I see some people hiding their hands immediately. This is just an example. I'm not criticizing anybody. People in nearby pews notice it, and at coffee hour, somebody starts whispering, "Isn't it awful that so-and-so came to church with dirty hands?" Obviously, they have no respect for the house of God. Well, Jesus would have something to say about that. He would say, it's not dirty fingernails in church that you should be ashamed of. You should be ashamed of the blots of unkindness and criticism on your spirit that cause you to open your mouth and gossip. Jesus has amazing insight. He knows that eating the wrong food or having dirty hands is not going to affect your spiritual life. He also knows that allowing mean-spiritedness, self-righteousness, and pride to flourish will stunt your soul. Your inner world will become a wasteland, full of dark holes and weeds, the habitation of scorpions, as the Psalms say. He's also really concerned about the effects that harboring evil will have on the people around you. The evils he lists hurt not only the individual who acts on them, but they also damage the community. Murder kills an individual, but it also breaks the social network and brings the burden of grief and oftentimes poverty to the family and friends of the victim and to the perpetrator. The betrayal of adultery shreds one of the basic building blocks of society. Fornication looks at other people as just objects to be used rather than as whole human beings. Theft invades the space that should be a safe harbor and steals the fruit of someone else's effort. False witness or lying presumes that you have power over someone and can manipulate the truth with no concern for how it might injure them. Slander is similar to lying and assumes that you have the right to demean people's characters. And racism. Racism assumes that God approves of one kind of person over another. Each of these evil acts stem from the self-focused assumption that I am of more value than others around me. What I want, what I think, what I feel is more important than anything else. Basically, it's individualism run amok. As soon as we begin to think that we are above others, better than others, or more deserving of property or respect, community begins to erode. People who lack respect for others will soon begin to assume that everyone is like them. Suspicion and paranoia grow and feed on themselves. Trust shrivels. And true communication and cooperation become impossible because everybody becomes guarded and watchful. Kindness and generosity die. They can't survive when everyone is suspicious of the giver's ulterior motives. You think that maybe I'm painting too bleak a picture or exaggerating? Jesus advises the disciples not even to try to combat the evil of the human heart because it's so contagious and so poisonous. And I think we see that. He says, if they are offended by the truth, leave those evil ones alone. Don't get close enough to them to debate with them. God will take care of it and will uproot the poisonous weeds. He continues, they're blind guides of blind people. And when one blind person guides another, they both fall into a pit. It kind of sounds to me like he's saying, it takes one to know one. You would have to be tarred with the same brush in order to get close enough to teach these people anything. Tradition has it that our hearts are a garden where we meet our Lord. And the fruits of the Spirit bloom there. Love, joy, peace, gentleness, patience, goodness, and faith. Religious law, the Ten Commandments and so forth, is the fence that surrounds and protects the garden. We are imperfect beings. And so unfortunately, there's also a serpent in each one of our gardens. If we're brave enough to look, we will discover plenty of malice inside of us, plenty of insidious poison ivy vines of envy, gossip, and judging. Our job is to support the growth of the good and beautiful things in our spirits and thus strengthen our community in Christ. And with God's help, that chokes out the briars and starves the serpent by refusing them the food and water of attention. And then we can step out and find ways to shine the light that heals on any lurking poison in us or around us. Amen. Affirm the faith of the church. We believe in
one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again, love. Come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayers of the people are found in your bulletin insert. In the name of our compassionate God, who cares for all people without difference or distinction, let us offer our prayers for the church and for the world, saying, "Hear us, O Holy One." For the church, especially Michael, our presiding bishop, and Kevin, our bishop, that we may be a sign of God's presence and a means for all people to come closer to God.
Hear us, O Lord.
For this parish family, that we may find welcome and healing at God's table, may gladly draw others who come seeking Jesus into the household.
Hear us, O Lord.
For the people of Lahaina, that God will hold them close, ease their pain, and give them courage and hope in these uncertain days following the fire.
Hear us, O Lord.
For peace in Ukraine and all places of conflict, that the light of God's countenance will spread the gift of God's grace, bringing peace to reign in the hearts of all.
Hear us, O Holy One.
In thanksgiving for the diverse gifts that God gives to us all, and the grace to rejoice in the lives of those who are different,
hear us, O Holy One.
For all who suffer from violence, injustice, and prejudice, and for those in need of our prayers, remembering
Patrick,
John,
Daphne,
William,
Noah,
Christopher,
Mother Gwendolyn
Jane,
Father Richard,
Archdeacon
Rick,
Deacon
Liz,
Jack,
Denise,
David,
Ann,
Jane,
Chris,
Steve,
Lisa,
Jackson,
Peyton,
Kathy,
Ann,
Sheila,
Art,
Bishop Paul,
Lisa,
Beth,
Gabrielle,
Marlene,
Wani,
Jen,
Beth,
Fran,
Violet,
Jack,
Jenny,
Greg,
Sandy,
Kenneth,
Jeff,
Glenda,
Julia,
David
and Cindy,
Jack
Sr.,
Bruce,
Brian,
Father John,
Lynn,
and those we may have offered from our own hearts. That God will strengthen them and sustain them each day.
Hear us, O Holy One.
For all the departed, remembering especially those we now name either silently or aloud. That they may feast at God's abundant table.
Hear us, O Holy One.
Lifting our voices with all creation, with Mary the God-bearer, Bartholomew the Apostle, Margaret, Benedict, and all the saints, let us offer ourselves and one another to the living God through Christ.
To you, O Lord, our God.
God of all nations, through faith in Jesus, the Canaanite woman found welcome at the table of your Son. Hear our prayers, and let our every word and deed show forth your love and mercy, until all are gathered into your one family. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen. Amen.
We confess that we have sinned against you through our own fault.
By what we have done and by what we have left undone, we have not loved you with our whole heart.
We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves.
We are truly sorry and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us. And we may delight in your will and walk in your ways. To the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen. Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Please be seated. A few of you have asked me about what's going on in Hawaii. So I would like to point you to the webpage that the Episcopal Diocese of Hawaii has put up, where they're giving the latest information about what's happening in Maui. And also on that page, they give you information in the event you want to donate in support of their efforts, their recovery efforts. They do ask, please, not to send stuff. People have been very, very generous in sending various kinds of supplies, but because the infrastructure is so damaged, they can't manage it. So if you want to donate, please donate finances. You can donate directly to the Episcopal Diocese of Hawaii or to Episcopal Relief and Development, which has a special area just for that. So the website is, big surprise, EpiscopalHawaii.org. Not hard to remember, EpiscopalHawaii.org. And speaking of donations, the Mincy Trails Boy Scout Troop has asked me to post a flyer about their special August food drive. Turns out that the local food pantries are in great need because Second Harvest Pantry doesn't have enough food. So I put it, oh, not there, the main entrance, not the side entrance, I put it up on the board. And you can find their website there to see what they're in need of. But they also have a QR thing that you can scan with your smartphone.
And that'll give you not only information about the current drive, which is August only, but it'll also give you information about the annual Scouting for Food drive, which happens in November, where they actually come and collect bags of food. So, good thing. We certainly support our Emmaus food pantry, but the problem seems to be getting bigger and not better. Matt West says that there are extra rocks and bricks left over from the labyrinth that are available for free pickup. And I've already scored a bucket full of bricks for my little tiny flower garden. So if you are interested in any of those things, see Matt, and he will make arrangements.
Or just grab some bricks and stuff. First come, first serve.
First come, first serve. And I believe that some people are coming this week. So if you're interested, see Matt today. Today is also the Regional Pride Festival, which this year is happening at Steel Stacks, and admission is free. The Diocese of Bethlehem and a number of our local parishes are there to carry the message, the Episcopal Church welcomes you. And Deacon Jen will be representing us at that festival. I think it goes from like 11 to
2 to 8.
And it's a beautiful day. And there's tons of parking, unlike when they had it in Allentown. It's much more convenient. So if you'd like to go over and make your Episcopal presence welcome, stop by the table and get a button or a sticker so that people know that they are welcome.
I'd like to invite you all to come downstairs to coffee hour. Two friends, Allison and I, decided to make it easy for each other. Now we almost have brunch. So please come down.
Walk in love, as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
Holy, 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 holy.
things come of thee, O Lord.
Of thine own have we given thee.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
God of all, creator of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise.
Glory to you, forever and ever.
At your command, all things came to be. The vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets in their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home.
By your will, they are created and have their being.
From the primal elements, you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the stewards of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another.
Have mercy, Lord, for we are sinners in your sight.
Again and again you called us to return. Through prophets and sages you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only Son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace.
By his blood he reconciled us. By his wounds we are healed.
And therefore we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
For on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends and said, take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks, and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Remembering now his work of redemption and offering to you this bread and cup, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving,
we celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming.
Sanctify these gifts by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Savior.
Come, Holy Spirit, breath of eternal life.
God of our holy ancestors, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, God of Deborah, Ruth, and Esther, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world without us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for power only and not for compassion, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this Holy Communion make us one body, one Spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name. Amen.
risen Lord, be known to us in the breaking of the bread.
Accept these prayers and praises, Father, through Jesus Christ, our great High Priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor, glory, worship, and praise, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Blood of Christ, the cup of salvation.
The body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Amen.
Blood of Christ, the cup of
body
salvation.
Of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Blood of Christ,
the body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Blood of Christ,
the body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Blood of Christ,
the body of Christ.
Bread of heaven.
The body of Christ.
The bread of heaven.
body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
The
body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Blood of Christ, the cup of salvation.
Body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Blood of Christ,
body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Blood of Christ,
the body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation.
You have fed us with the bread of life and cup of salvation. You have united us with Christ and one another, and you have made us one with all your people in heaven and on earth. Now send us forth in the power of your Spirit, that we may proclaim your redeeming love to the world and continue forever in the risen life of Christ our Savior. Amen.
God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit.
Thanks be to God.